always presented as being almost a kind of a non-verdict, as if some kind that the jury have shirked their responsibility. And those who have, as they would see it, lost out to a not proven verdict, it's presented as guilty, people are walking free. Now, there is an element of language in this. In actual fact, you don't need these words. You don't need proven, not proven. You don't even need guilty or not guilty. Because if you have a religious belief, you would adhere to the view that only your God knows who is truly guilty. A guilty verdict simply means that a group of people on a given day thought the case had been proved. A different group of people on a different day might take a totally different view. You see, what you could do is to say, well, the obligation is on the Crown to prove its case beyond reasonable doubt. When it comes to delivering a verdict, it's the answer to the question, yes or no. And the verdict should be either yes or no. You don't need guilty, not guilties, and that kind of emotive language. And a lot of it is language. Is it because guilty somehow carries with it, yes, guilty. Guilty man goes to jail. Not guilty, it's a stamp of innocence. Well, it's nothing of the sort, I'm afraid. It's simply that a jury on a given day didn't think the Crown case was proved.